Hey folks, I'm Harry Enten, a senior political writer and analyst here at CNN. And now with the election in the books, we can look back at the results, which seem to indicate that President-elect Joe Biden won an election that few other Democrats may have been able to win. Although the national popular vote isn't particularly close, Joe Biden holds less than a point lead in the key battleground states of Arizona, Georgia, and Wisconsin. Without winning at least one of those states, Joe Biden would fall short of the necessary 270 electoral votes to become the next president. Results in Pennsylvania are also tight. In all four of those states, Biden is running ahead of House Democratic candidates. Indeed, in all four, they're actually trailing their Republican opponents when you add up all the votes statewide. This gets right at the heart of Biden's primary pitch, that he was more electable than the other Democratic candidates running.
We have to beat Donald Trump. And all the polls agree Joe Biden is the strongest Democrat to do the job.
One of the reasons why Biden was able to sneak by Trump is that more voters saw him as moderate. That stands in direct contrast to 2016, when pre-election polls indicated that Trump was seen as more moderate than his then Democratic opponent, Hillary Clinton. And being seen as moderate likely boosted Biden's favorability rating. A majority of voters viewed Biden favorably. He won the lion's share of those voters. This is a very different picture than what occurred in 2016. When a sizable portion of the electorate viewed neither Hillary Clinton nor Donald Trump favorably. Trump won those voters by 17 percentage points, and with them, the presidency. We can see how Biden's moderate pitch may have helped him in 2020. Just look at Nebraska's 2nd congressional district. Biden won the district, and with it an electoral vote, by over 5 percentage points. In the House contest in that same district, the Republican Dom Bacon defeated Democrat Kara Eastman by over 5 points. So what was the difference between Biden and Eastman? How about the fact that Eastman was backed by the progressive group Justice Democrats and was in support of both Medicare for All and the Green New Deal? Biden on both of those issues backed a more incremental approach. At the end of the day, Biden's differences with these other Democrats may not have swung a lot of votes, but in a close election, just a few votes was just enough.